Hey everybody, this is a tutorial to install n8n, or n8n as people call it, in very cost-effective and cheaper way than other people do it, but slightly more complex. We are going to use a service called Hetzner to host our web servers, and we are going to install something called Dokploy on it to then run n8n on it. So I'm going to guide you through this as a very quick tutorial so you can follow along. First, what you want to do is you want to create an account on Hetzner. Hetzner.com/cloud is a platform where you can buy very cheap virtual machines that run any kind of operating that you want, operating system that you want, but you can run Ubuntu, for example. And you can see it costs you around €3.80 before tax. After tax, it's like €4.30 or so. And this is a very cheap and cost-effective way to run your n8n instance. I'm going to show you also what we're going to install on it. This is Dokploy. This is a cloud version that you can use if you want to, then you don't need Hetzner. But what we want to do is use Hetzner because of how cheap the cloud service is that they have and how much performance you also get out of it compared to other services that you can use to host your n8n instance. And you can see when you go to dokploy.com, you can see here there is a command to run. This is then what we are going to use to install it. First, go ahead and create the Hetzner account. You can use the link in the description and get €20 of free discount whenever you buy a virtual machine. As soon as you logged in, I created already a project here. It's called tutorials, and we're going to I quickly guide you through how to set up the instance. It's pretty simple to do. So this is in your project on Hetzner Cloud. You want to go over to servers here and create a new server, like add server. And then you can see you have multiple options. The cheapest options are in Europe. The other options are more expensive, but also an option for you if you are in the US or in Asia. That one, what you want to do is you want to keep this as default, this Ubuntu image as it's configured already. Now you can see what options you have to choose from. And you can go even cheaper here. You can go the Intel version, which I am going to do because I have even more RAM and it's even cheaper. So you can see it costs like €3.29 per month here. And then I can scroll down, networking, I can leave it as is. If you have an SSH key and if you know how to use an SSH key, you can add it here so you don't have to provide passwords to log in later. I'm going to use my SSH key here, but you can also leave that out and then Hetzner will send you an email with the username and the password to log in. Volumes you can leave empty, firewalls empty, backups as well. And then all the way on the bottom, you can give this a name here. I call it n8n Production. And then I can click buy. This is very quickly set up. It really takes less than a minute. You can see here I already have an IP address and this is what I need. Now the instance is already running. And then with this IP address or when you get an email, when you don't have added an SSH key, now we can use this to log in. So I'm going to share my terminal and you can find on your computer. If you're using Mac, you can find an app called Terminal or a command prompt on Windows. I'm going to quickly share mine. So now if you have your terminal open, this is my terminal here. I'm going to zoom in a bit. So I'm going to log in using this IP address that I just copied before. So I can use SSH root at and then this IP address. And then you get asked if you want to accept this, you can say yes. This is adding this IP address to the known hosts so that when next time if you log in and this tells you that something is broken, then this is more secure for you. So you're not going to get hacked or anything or connect to the wrong instance. So now you can see it logged in. It's all good. I called it n8n production, so it's also called n8n production here. And now from the Dokploy website, I'm going to quickly share this again. We want to copy this install script here. So I'm going to copy that here. Now we can run this, so I paste it here and execute it. And this will now install everything that is required to use Dokploy. It uses Docker as a main way of deploying your applications, n8n for example. This is also usually very quick. You can see that the instance is actually pretty capable. It has 2 virtual cores and 4 GB of memory, so it's pretty powerful for what you get for the money. I think we're gonna skip here until this is done. It usually takes maybe 1 or 2 minutes. And as soon as this is done and everything is downloaded and installed, you get a link to access your instance. Okay, so now that it is done, we get a link here. It's almost not visible in my terminal. You get an IP address plus a port. So if you click on that, you are greeted with this interface. And this is the server setup. So you can provide your name and some password and then register your user, it will greet you with this project screen. So now you are basically only one step away from hosting your own n8n instance. You create a project, call it n8n, and then you create a new service. And here you want to choose from template. So you choose template, then you can deploy all kinds of apps that you want to. But here I want to deploy n8n or n8n, and I click search for it and click on create. You can select server, and we don't have to do this because that's an optional thing. If you want to install it on an existing server, you just click confirm here, and then it will install that service into your n8n project. So you can go here, and now this is not done. You have to still click deploy, and I will create another video how you are going to deploy this onto your own domain or connect your own domain with n8n or with Dokploy, so you can run any kind of service website on your own domain. But this time we are just going to use the IP address for it. There is one thing that we have to configure before we can hit deploy here. If you go to the environment tab here and then click on the view icon to show the content because it's obfuscated. And here n8n is expecting a host from us. And currently that's some kind of domain that we don't have. And here we are going to provide the IP address from the Hetzner server. So in our Hetzner interface, you can get this IP address from your Hetzner server here. Then go back. And then you can provide it here. You can say, want to add this IP address like this. Okay, and then after you edited your environment and added the IP address, we're going to go to general back and click deploy. And then you say confirm. And now it's deploying n8n. And so you can watch this happening. It's running here. You can also click on view to see what is going on. You can see what it's doing. And as soon as this is done, you can access your heat. Okay, and then when it's deployed and it says it's running on the deployments and it's green here, we can open our IP address that we used as a host in the environments. So you can see, as I said before, I've specified the IP address here. One thing that I forgot to mention is that you also have, before you hit deploy, to go to the domain section here and click on edit. And instead of some example domain, just add the IP address here as well. And just say the service name is n8n again, and then click save and then hit deploy. If you do this afterwards, no worries, you can just hit deploy again. It will deploy again. And then you open the IP address in your browser, and then you have n8n running. So that's how you get it going. So I can do the same here. I create an account, and then as soon as I'm in, and I can get a free license key, of course, do this because it gives you workflow history, advanced debugging, and execution search. I don't do it because I don't gonna keep this n8n instance here. And then you can start. Then you're ready. So you can create your first workflow. For example, I'm going to send an email to a friend when I click a button, so I can set it up, create credentials, etc., etc. If you want to know more about n8n and how to create workflows, how to automate things, let me know in the comments. I'm going to create more videos how to do this in the future. Also share with you possible ways to make your life easier with automations, using AI, integrate with all kinds of services, etc. n8n has a whole bunch of apps that you can by default connect. You can see here, if I scroll down this list, these are all apps and services that n8n supports out of the box that you can connect to. And I'm going to share how to utilize this to the max. Thank you for watching. That is it. I hope you liked it. And for the next video, I'm going to show you how to connect your custom domain to your n8n instance.